Hello out there, I'm the Bastard and this is Chris Coreline.
Hello everyone and happy Thursday.
Happy Thursday, although you might not be watching this on a Thursday, but you know, if you don't want to, I guess you could break continuity by doing that. So this looks to be the last episode in our random trap set playthrough of Orcs Must Die 2 and all the Orcs Must Die 2 DLC. Sad times.
But hopeful times as well. Hopeful.
Yeah, because we may go on to play a better game. Or more entertainingly for you. For those people who watched the last episode, obviously it was the penultimate episode, which left us with a sour taste in our mouth as we had bitter, bitter defeat. Is that the first time we've been defeated on War Mage as well? I think it might be.
Do you know what? If I don't have a sour taste anymore because I'm the starving man who is fed lemons and is happy about it. Defeat is a way of life for us.
Yes. So, in any case, here we are in the last level, Chilled Cavern. We haven't actually even beaten this on War Mage, let alone Nightmare. So, if we actually beat it on War Mage, that'll be a lovely first. And to be honest, given the crappy traps we got last time, well, fate has been kind to us, hasn't it, Christopher?
Yes, it's beautiful in here.
It really is. I'm very pleased with the traps we've rolled. I have got Scepter of Domination, which I put extra charm on. Extra charm? Oh, no, extra damage to charmed enemies. Dwarven Missile Launcher, which with secondary attack, the flak, consuming less mana. Which is lovely. Floor Scorchers with being able to mount it on a wall. And because of the small space we're going to be using them in, I selected Burns Targets Longer rather than Wider Arc. Web Spinners with Burning Webs cause more damage because we've got quite a lot of fire stuff. Dart Spitter with Charm because we have no barricades. So Charm Dart Spitters are lovely. Yep. And Archers with Fire Arrows, which are going to be great together with the Missile Launcher for Flyer Control. Yep. So I'm pretty pleased with that. And Christopher?
Yeah, so to compliment the Bastard's pretty good luck, I also had pretty good luck. I am rocking the big spiky thing, the spike gate, spike wall.
Spike wall, yes.
That is upgraded to stun. I have the ubiquitous tar, which has been upgraded to slow further. Four will be the pounder, my sealing trap, which I think, again, is stun. Yeah, because the other option is Ogre's Drop of Coins, which is about as much use as flipping syphilis.
Yes.
Number five is the Healing Fountain, which is not as clutch as a bear trap, but still pretty good. And the final thing is the Rage thing, which is
Berserker Trinket, which you're going to be slowly killing yourself with through the course of this game.
It would seem so.
So first things I would suggest, I suppose. I'm going to bang some archers somewhere, certainly. Maybe I'll wait for the archers. One thing that occurs to me for the wall traps is I believe both sides are similar in that they have like an area that's kind of a flat wall straight through. This one is slightly different. Okay. I think it's worth kind of alternating spike walls and web spinners. So if you put like a spike wall here-ish, I wouldn't put it so it's flinging them towards the rift like you've done there. If you put one of them at, like, the beginning.
Yep. And one of them at the end.
Yeah. And again, probably not that way around. There we go.
No, that is right.
Can it not go flush against the wall, against the kind of pillar, or?
Yeah, sure, probably can.
Flush. Yeah, but there's no space for a web spinner, otherwise it's wasted space. So I'm going to put in a web spinner there.
I will actually do some early setup on the far side. I'm going to put a healing wall down here.
Really? Because are we ever going to be there?
It's a fallback position, but I can move it up if you want.
And I tell you what.
I tells the what.
I'm going to put a dart spitter there. I'm going to put dart spitters all down the center, and then you can feel free to fill the rest with pounders.
Cool. Oh, this is a bit weirder, yeah. So, fling that way. Fling that way, yeah?
Yep. Okay. I don't think a spike wall is going to be useful on the other side there. So on this, yeah, on the, you have read my mind exactly. So, yeah, and I'll pop dart spitter in a... if I can fit a dart. I think I can exactly fit. Ooh, nearly ran off the edge. A dart spitter and a floor scorcher in here, which is nice. So I will do just that, and then
I have enough money for one tar. How so you do put I your... put?
Where do I put the floor scorchers here? That's a good question, isn't it?
Tip them backwards.
Or put them like that. Yeah, so here, probably on the other side, we'll do floor scorchers like a long one side like that, because it's a side you're unlikely to walk on. And here, if we put like a row of floor scorchers pointing this way here, and then fill the rest with tar. Yes, yeah, you are perfectly right. There we go. That looks good to me. So I shall go over to the other side, I suppose. We haven't got any archers out yet, but that's fine. I'll put them out when I'm good and ready. And yeah, I guess I'm ready to go. And I can do a bit of snipage from up here, which is quite nice, because hopefully that means we can get any goblin sappers that come out. Like that one. Or you. You stay there. And you stay there. Charm that Yeti.
Charmed.
Oh, I thought you were dead. And you're not.
I'm going to activate the rage because you're right by healing well. Because I'm right by healing well.
Yeah, because I don't think it actually hurts me.
It hurts me. Here you go.
I think charm is going to be very, very useful here.
God, those knocks occasionally knocks back heavy enemies. Oh my lord. You in control up there?
Oh, yes. I briefly wasn't, but, you know, it's fine. Okay, I'm going to load up with some archers. I'm going to put an archer there and an archer there.
Here we go.
Here we go indeed. Goblin sappers are going to be difficult coming out of that rift near you.
That
very
one.
Difficult, yeah. You have to watch for that.
Welcome to my kill box, gentlemen. Oh. That looked painful. Do you know what's a good idea? Sacrificial traps.
Yeah, that is good. Like barricades with normal sappers.
Yeah. Okay, so we're actually losing a bit back here. That's okay, it's okay. One goblin sack. We just took out my entire...
You okay?
Just about? Very.
Watch out for runners.
Yeah, I got a runner here.
Oops, stunned.
Nice, that was cartoon-alicious. That was proper ting tang wallow bing bang right there. Are we recording now? Oh god, did I just say that on air?
Yes, we are in fact recording now, Christopher.
Oh god.
Okay.
Do you want to swap sides so we can
load up a bit? Potion? Yeah, no, that's a good idea.
Second good idea of the month.
Yeah. Whoa, crap. Your side's a lot more difficult.
Flak needed.
Is it? I'm pretty sure my archers could take care of that. Ah, you put pounders down the middle.
Bad idea.
Yeah, I want my dart spitters there.
Okay, we'll fix it at the go break.
Which we should get one next, I think.
Oh yes, we are still in. This is definitely not War Mage. Am I kidding? Oh, this definitely is War Mage.
Yeah, it definitely is War Mage. Yes. What's that noise?
Hey, rage is active.
Okay, that's better. Yeah. Thank you. And then we'll pop.
Oh god, this is a. There's no space there. Oh, that's just because there's a rock. Okay. I want a rock! Where are you going?
There's a pounder in the middle on this other side as well.
Yes, I know, I'm on my way.
I didn't know you knew, Christopher. I was just making a casual remark.
You're worse than my wife.
Worse than your non-existent wife.
Do you know what? We should come back one. There's no point in putting them up there.
Okay.
Yeah, we are still...
Which of us has a more effective weapon combination? Because they should definitely be on that other side.
Super duper you.
Okay.
OMG you. For flyers, though...
It's fine for flyers either way. The archers can take care of the flyers for now, and I can always duck back and use flak. So it's okay. Fine. It's fine.
There are no healing wells in front of and behind the pillbox.
Okay.
Which is pretty broken when paired with.
Is that
the,
an efficient use of cash?
With the rage trinket, I think it's pretty darn vital.
But
because I can just negate the cost.
Yeah, but they're only the for you. Trinket. Like the rage trinket doesn't damage me.
Yeah, but I'm important.
But when do we ever run out in front of the kill box?
I frequently run out in front of the kill box.
Oh, I never do.
I can sell them, but they are dirt cheap.
I definitely think we should sell the ones out front. Are they? How much is dirt cheap?
Like 600.
Like at the minute that's like two tar traps? I don't know. It's up to you, man. He said in a voice that made it very apparent that he thought it was a terrible idea.
Yeah, well, my mother thought I was a terrible idea.
I have no doubt of that. Right. Begin the lesson.
Oh no, you don't. Oh lord, the whole kill box.
Well, I'm near. I think I'm nearly done over here, so. Oh, I've got a couple of ogres to get rid of, actually.
It's okay, it's under control.
Okay. Well, I'm done. Oh no, not quite done. Hello, ogre. Die.
Hello, ogre.
Right. Oh, crap. And fucking healer. Raising him up.
Blap. Healer. Squelchicated. Let me squelchicate you on the manor upon of your demise is.
Just let him into the kill box.
I'd love to. Was that healing wall that's useless?
Not that. The ones in front, the ones you weren't using. Okay, let's whack some more floor scorchers down.
I've got all traps, that's a bit rare.
You fucking bastards! The thing is, unlike most of the DLCs in this game, I think the main problem with this one, which is, it's definitely my least favourite DLC, and I think the main problem with it is that the Goblin Sappers just aren't enjoyable. Like, they make any attempt you make to make traps work pointless, which is kind of the point of Orcs Must Die. So, I got quite a lot of breakthrough here. And my archers apparently are doing shit all, which is weird. They're literally ignoring monsters running right behind them, which isn't great. Yeah, the Goblin Sappers I'm really not a fan of at all. I know they were trying to get, your traps are not safe, but it's like, well, yeah, but that means...
But that's why we bought the game.
Yeah.
Yeah, so. Try that, sit in the back line raising people, see how I care. I'm
still alive.
About three of these little healer squiggles, okay, they're done.
Okay.
Right, okay, so what else do we need trap-wise? Let's up the tar.
Probably could do with a couple more archers. Okay, I think that's a wasted archer. Never mind. Because I don't think you can see anything.
I think I'm in your kill box. I might look like you here. Youch. Okay. Yeah, try that one twice. A flag. Rage is up.
Thank you.
Right. Not that you need to worry about it. It's not like Mana Rage where... Oh dear, this is bad news.
What's bad news?
Goblin Sapper, real box.
Oh. It happens. Are you genuinely struggling?
No, I
think... Not that I can really fucking do a thing about it. Ah, you... Absolute asshole. Swamp Troll's bad news. Oh, this is bad. Oh, no, it's not so bad. Apparently...
Once you make your mind up, it's very difficult to do inline risk assessments when you keep changing the criteria of the project. Oh my god.
I assume we'll get a go break, at which point we should swap again.
ATCB using work talk for fun times since about 6 months ago.
I'm on my way.
I'm fine.
Ah, I'm done. So
cool. Let
I might
me,
as well start putting
just
down some traps.
Give you a little bit more tar before I leave.
Okay.
Something's stuck. You are still here. You've got more coming your way. Be warned!
Okay. I'll let the killbox kill him because I want to sell this archer. Although, I think, yeah, we'll have a cut break anyway. So that's fine. Right. Yeah, I wanted you to go there.
So if you have the money for one more dart spitter, there's a lovely space for over here.
Well, they're nearly flush up there. I'll see what I have after I. This is what I need. That and that.
Fundamentally.
I will have enough for one more, I think. Yes, I will. Okay.
Just want to put these down here.
Extending the kill box,
are
we?
Do I want to put those down there?
It's not a bad idea.
Well, it's not a good idea.
It's using up goblin sappers, which is nice.
Well, they only go if they get killed, though. That's the problem. Don't trigger exactly.
No, they explode. No, when they explode when they set off, when they freeze traps.
Which is the better kill box?
Right now, I'm not sure. The better kill box is probably this one. I think. Okay. I don't know.
The question is to decide which way.
Well, just well, remove it, and I'll put like I can put web spinners there when we.
Okay. Well, I've got nothing else to spend my money on. You can buy archers.
Don't you have tar? Like and pounders.
Yeah, but there's all kinds of spaces.
There's loads of spaces for them. Loads and loads.
None on the other side, though.
Well, then put them on this side. Is there no spaces of pounders on the other side? Are you sure?
It is teched out over there. It is bling. It's like the alloy wheels of kill boxes.
There are so many spaces for pounders.
There's
so
really
many spaces.
Oh, there are
spaces. There are so many spaces.
Where?
How about, like, any of the... Like, there?
This is
and
a rock.
There?
That's a hard
and
place.
There?
That's another rock.
Alright, okay. well, there's a space for a tar there.
There's a space for a tar there. I might do have one mana for tar. Oh no, there isn't. There's a rock there, even though it's very small.
All right, okay. Well, any tar, like you could put just tar further down, and it'll spring the zappers. And tar's always just useful anywhere. Okay, you could put some tar down by here, actually, because those archers are firing on them as they come through, so that might not be a bad notion.
The good thing about tar is it triggers on all enemies, not just N enemies. It doesn't reset. Yeah. Right.
So, which side do you want me to take?
Your side, really. I suppose I can place more pounders on the side that you're on right now.
Okay, so we'll go over here. I suspect this is still the hardest, because even though it's packed with stuff, sappers can reduce that pretty quickly, and they come straight in from the other. There's a sapper coming over your side.
Yeah, I see him.
And a sapper coming over my side. If I can just get rid of him. Okay, he only took out a couple.
There's like a bunt ton of flyers.
Well, the archer should be able to take care of them. Enough chance they can't. There's not that many. What are you talking about, Christopher Coreline? You little bastard. Oh, and then there's nothing
Splat.
Coming in. And there's an orc just standing there waiting for me to shoot him in the face.
I'm going to have to find another game where I'm allowed a blunderbuss because this is OP.
Is
this the first time the viewers get a chance to see you with the Staff of Domination?
No, we definitely had more in the vanilla playthrough and stuff. We definitely had quite a few. Random ones come in, watch out for those runners.
They are getting far.
Yeah, the tar down there I think was pretty good because this these waves from down there are thinned out quite a lot. Look at that.
Should have thought of that. We'll think of that during Nightmare.
Anyway, I'm going to use this time to see what I can put up. I'm going to put up some extra archers, actually, because they are useful for more than...
I promised I would do with the extra pounders. Magic trousers. Welcome.
Hang on, swap sides.
Hey.
I'm just going to pop archers up there.
Lol.
You alright over on that side?
Yep.
Okay. Watch out for Thunderbats.
Thunderbats are on the loose. Thunderbats are loose. They're like goths, but also Thundercats. Thunderbats are loose.
I believe the line is hear the magic, hear the roar.
I believe the line is your face. Oh god. Oh man, that hurts.
What is going on, and do you need help?
Trouble, and yes.
Right. Well, I can't really leave this side, really, so I don't know why I even asked. You've got
it's
archers
okay,
over
okay.
there backing you up.
Just about got control of the situation again. Whee! Whew! Hey, Matt.
Yes?
You don't fancy our chances on Nightmare.
For the last time, I will say I don't fancy our chances on Nightmare. Oh god. It's like saying goodbye to a lover. Okay, let's swap sides. Because I think
really?
I am better on that side. Yep.
The tar game has been upped.
Little bastards.
Is that what you'll call your children?
If I had any children, I would call them little bastards.
This is not the place for you. Return to your own lands and use your nation's own welfare system.
Right, my side's done.
This side is an absolute non-issue.
Whee. Got a ogre and a troll on the way up. But shouldn't be a problem. Especially not if I charm them. They still there?
Now fights. They are, because they have two little healing bollocks behind them.
Alright, I'll take care of the swamp troll if you take care of the healers. Watch out for the swamp troll.
Duty of care fields.
Shut up.
Don't keep charming him, gods.
I do more damage to him if he's charmed.
That's really bad.
I can hurt my friends more than my enemies.
Anyway, 5 skulls.
No, GG. 4 skulls. Sure. 4 skulls. No splits. Yeah, not bad. Not bad at all.
That's a first for us, under any circumstances, recording or otherwise.
No, we're always
great. We never won that game, have we?
Oh, no, yeah, we've never... No, actually, we have. We must have done, because we had a skull there. So we're just lying, which is complete lies. We don't care about you at all.
So I'm going to put the tar here, first trap, because, oh my god, that was brilliant.
Okay. I'm just going to basically do what we did, I think.
Absolutely.
Only fail, probably. Yeah.
Actually, do you know what? Let's keep it exactly the same.
Yep. I think probably for the best. And then what else was there? Oh, yes, this. Okay.
Build to the traps you have. No, other side.
Okay.
Other player is ready, but Chris is not ready.
Yeah.
So game will wait. Game and viewers alike. What's your wall traps again?
Web spinner.
You've only got space for one there, okay. Sorry about this, viewers at home. And I will take your advice, and we will only use one of the... Okay!
Let's go.
Wow, fire's already.
Is there? Shit! Yep. Oh god! I was not anticipating flyers already.
That's what they call it, nightmare mode. Back when you got a chance, they're getting very close.
Yep. Done.
Teamwork.
Which side do you want? The other side, good. Is there more of them? No.
Well, didn't you just ruin my day? Oh, a whole live Yeti. Great.
Oh my god, swamp troll already.
Yeah, bad news. Bridge is on.
Lots of charming. Lots of death.
It is bad here right now. We are going to lose points.
It is moderately under control here. I need to get rid of a swamp troll though, so, you know. Die. Right, on my way. After I pick up coins.
Okay, we just got control.
Okay, I will stay on that side then, and then I will start laying down some archers.
We have some time now because there is a troll there. And
I've done it. I've put down some archers. Once it actually finishes, I should be able to put down another one.
Are
you ready?
Invite him into this kill box just so we can get some DPS on him, and then we'll kubo.
Do we need to swap sides? Because you intimated that the other side was harder, which probably means I need to be on it with
what
charm.
What are you implying?
That I have charm.
Time to talk about other people's kill boxes. Move it.
That sounds like flyers to me. Yep. Gnolls. Oh my god. Are you serious?
You can null be serious. We have lost box one.
Lost what?
I am in dire need of health, which I've left up here. Yes, clutch healing well.
This kill box has just died. Oh god. Oh god, this is bad. This is so bad. They're all here. They're all here, Chris, and they've killed our archers, and now they're here for me. Seriously, I think he's lost. Oh god! Oh god!
I'm doing fine over here. If you feel, it's down to you.
I'm not joking. I totally wasn't joking, by the way.
Oh, and with that.
And with that ignominious defeat.
Bombshell. I was doing grand. This is totally down to you. Basically, if we can take one lesson from this, and it's a microcosm lesson for the whole series, it's that you are welcome, because I've totally carried you.
And I'm sure the viewers will agree with that, as long as they don't go back and watch any of the other videos. So there we go. That's the end of the third installment of Orcs Must Die DLC. Are we there, Yeti? And the end of our random trap set playthrough of Orcs Must Die 2, a series that began on the very first day of the channel with the very first video. Wow. And
please stop begging for additional episodes, because it just cannot happen.
It's just embarrassing now, guys.
It's not happening. We've literally had to turn off comments on some of our videos
at
request of YouTube due to just traffic.
Yeah.
So please.
For anyone not picking up on that, this is one of the least successful series on the channel. And that's saying quite a lot, because not many people watch our videos. Not our video game ones, anyway. Certainly not the ones with Chris in. We've enjoyed playing this. And hopefully you've enjoyed watching it. If not, why are you still here? That's weird. It's weird. You need to find something better to do with your time. So thanks. Thank you very much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, as usual. And check out the other series on the channel. Do let us know if you do want more Orcs Must Die content. We've got some endless stuff we could play without random traps. We've already done a little bit of that.
At this stage, we will do basically whatever you tell us to, as long as the view counters are going up.
Essentially, if someone asks us to do it, we'll do it, because no one ever asks us for anything. So
we'll
now is your chance.
We'll even play naked.
We'll start doing that. Yeah. I'm not naked. Don't worry, Chris. I only have
totally
pants on.
Totally naked right now.
I do only have pants on.
I have negative pants on.
Negative pants. There is actually, you flayed your genitals and bum.
No, No, they're made of antimatter. Don't think about it too
much. Okay, I wasn't anyway, so that's good. Let's stop talking and wave goodbye to the brave. If anyone has actually watched this series from beginning to end, congratulations. Well done. Thank you. Thank you for your support.
You've won 16 bastard points.
Yes, and you can spend them at our bastard store, located at www.imaginarywebaddress.com. So, yeah. Bye.
Bye-bye.